Whew. Rise and grind, my people. Rise and grind. Let's go. Okay. Let's talk about the oval. Okay, girl. I see you. Y'all excuse that. That's my car telling me, girl, take the brake off. Okay. So, anyway, let's talk about the oval, y'all, which was, to me, a little boring again. I don't know. I mean, we're going to, like I said, we just gonna have to let it play itself out and see what's really going on. Okay. All right. So, moving right along. Nancy and Richard. Let's talk about Nancy and Richard. Okay. So Richard, like, you know, he in his mind, I guess he thinking he gotta get rid of this car, which, you know, that's, I think it's just a reaction as a father trying to, you know, do whatever. And of course, Barry acting clueless as usual, you know, not knowing what's really going on, you know, not knowing what's really going on. So I still don't understand why this woman just sitting up in the house, just laying on the couch. Girl, I just don't understand it. But anyway, we've been in this one day for a very long time, you know? It's like, and we have yet to see Barry get a little sense, you know? Now, at least he didn't went to bed, okay? We need him to go to bed and change his damn clothes. Go, like Sharon said, go take a shower. Damn. You've been running your ass around, acting a damn fool. Go take a shower. So, I guess Nancy find out about the car and the gun and all of that. She's finding all of this out. And I don't really understand the whole gun in the car and it going into a house, because she just, it don't make sense, okay? It don't make sense. And we saw where they were parked. What type of bullet was that? Okay? I don't know. But, needless to say, we're gonna go on over here to this White House, okay? So, Victoria continued to be the dark person that she is. So she has to, you know, talk crazy to the chef and, you know, tell her she fake because she's acting like a human being, you know, and don't really treat anybody like trash. She's doing her, basically, she's doing her job. So, you know, Victoria can't understand why somebody is human, I would assume. You know, she's a dark person, so she thinks that's fate, which is really not fate. She doing what she's supposed to do. Okay? Anyway, anyway, she's basically, you know, telling Victoria, you know, the staff really does love what they do, and they're going to, the senior staff is going to protect the president and the wife. They're gonna always do that. So that whenever there's a situation that needs attention, they're going to bring in the senior staff. Okay, so you know, she did give her advice and say, you know, y'all really need to put on a united front, you know. So, she low-key giving her advice to Victoria listening. She ear hustling and all of that. And bam, here come, you know, this lady come in and say, oh, your dad is on the phone. And this look on Victoria's face. And I'm like, wait a minute. Could there be somebody that Victoria is afraid of? Could it be? So apparently it is. person must be her dad. We don't know who that is. I'm curious to see exactly who that is, because apparently her dad is what got them where they are. I guess that's how they got where they are in the mayor, governor, office, all those. That's why they where they are today. That's why they are in the position they are today. And their expectations from him is not to do what they're doing. So in Victoria's mind, somebody's running back telling him, you know, and you know, and the president, you can see it on his face that he's tired, you know, whatever they've been going through on being in these political positions, he's being forced to do it and he's getting tired. But in my opinion, if you've spent all this time, you know, getting to where you are in these different positions, why are you doing what you're doing? It's almost like he's giving up. So he's trying to do something. You know, it's almost like he's trying to do something to make him get out of his position. You know, he's not taking the opportunity to try to make the situation better. No, what he's doing is almost like he's not really showing any initiative on making things better. Okay, all right. So apparently, at least we know that much. Whatever the case may be, something about that father, you know, Victoria has fear of. Okay. But Victoria also took her dark ass, and when I call her dark, I'm talking about her soul, okay? I ain't talking about her skin, baby. I'm talking about her soul. She goes and she had to let Gail know that Picky is dead. And so it's about two or three other guys that was out there. So it's almost like I don't understand that type of behavior with Victoria. It's just, I don't know. I mean, she's just horrible. She's a horrible person. I'll put it that way. Now, I can say, and this is where, you know, the son, okay? I kind of felt bad for him a little bit, because you could tell that he don't want to be there. It's like he know how crazy and how dark his family is, and he's just like, I want out, you know. And he, you know, you can tell, you know. And I think, you know, it's kind of weighing on him. It's like, you know, look what she did to my sister. You know, my sister jumped out of a car. You know, I don't know. This family right here, baby, I think it's a whole lot more we gonna hear about them. Okay. But, you know, overall, it was a little boring to me, because I was expecting a little bit more this time. But I guess I keep thinking the last one was, you know, this week, but I guess apparently there's another one next week. I guess we'll know more next week, you know, on that piece. But if you go back to Nancy and Richard, they still got this woman up in the house. She, you know, she wrote down a list of places that they are, but she's basically telling Nancy, y'all can't protect me. I know I'm gonna die when they find me. They're gonna kill me. You know, so I need you to record me, because I need to put this on tape, you know. And she gave them a list of places where, you know, they are, but they move around a lot. And she shot herself in the head in the dining room. So I don't think they're going to make it to the police department to take Perry, because they got a whole nother issue. Okay? They got a whole another issue going on. Okay? So, last but not least, I'm assuming Rich is going to get his job back because, you know, the president basically asked asked Donald to hire Richard back because, of course, the head maid was like, y'all need to, you know, he keeps this place under, you know, wraps, so you need to really hire him back. So they gonna do that. Then I haven't even gotten on Donald. Okay, and Lily's still doing her half-ass questioning. You know, Lily don't have no I don't even know how to describe it. That little bullshit scene that we saw, it was like, you know, girl, stop asking about the damn man. Damn the man. You need to try to find out why the hell somebody trying to set you up, sis. Okay? That's what you need to do. Shit. But we all know who it is. It's Cal crazy ass. Cal still trying to get back with Donald. Donald's like, nah, would you, you know, yes you do, Donald. You want his ass. Yes you do. But you trying to play hard to get. But you know, Cal then slithered his way up into protecting the president, you know? So, you know, that puts him at a closer range to Donald. That's who, you know, that's what that is. But all in all, we're gonna see how it goes. I mean, next week the mama Victoria mama's supposed to show up. Okay? We gonna see where the hell this demon spawn came from. We gonna see where that. We gonna see all that. I don't know if I'm ready for that, baby. I'm gonna have to have my white sage when this woman come up in here, because baby, that's gonna be too much. I don't know. You know. So, I mean, that's pretty much it, y'all. I mean, unless, you know, y'all tell me what y'all thought. I know a lot of people have some negative things to say about the Oval, but I'm gonna give it the benefit of the doubt, y'all. I'm gonna try to chill out, and I'm gonna check it out and see what's really, how it's gonna end. Because, you know, sometimes you just gotta give these shows a chance. You know, you gotta give these new actors a chance. Let them get warmed up and get comfortable. So, you know, I need Barry to start opening his damn mouth when he's mad. Stop clenching your damn cheeks. I hate it. So, but Nancy slapped the shit out of him, didn't she? She should did that shit way back in the third motherfucking episode. But nevertheless, y'all. See you next week.
I think I've had enough. I might get a little drunk. I say what's on my mind. I might do a little time. Cause all of my kindness is taken for weakness. Now I'm